Namaste. In this clipping, first we will discuss the basic differences between domestic income and national income, and then we will move on to see how to calculate the domestic income on the national income given certain aggregates, the adjustments that are to be made to finally arrive at the domestic income or national income will be discussed. First, to start up with the basic differences between domestic income and national income. Domestic income is very much a territorial concept, whereas national income is a national concept. Why is domestic income a territorial concept? Because it refers to the value of all the final goods and services that is produced within the domestic territory. Therefore, it is called as the territorial income. Whereas national income refers to value of all the final goods and services that is produced by the normal residents in the entire world. That is, from within the domestic territory and also from rest of the world, because it includes domestic income and also NFIA. So national income concept is a national concept, whereas the domestic income concept is a territorial concept. That's the first point of difference. Number two, domestic income takes into account all the production units or all the producers, no matter whether they are normal residents or non-residents, as long as they are within the domestic territory, all such producers and production units will be considered, and the value of the products generated by them or the income generated by them will be treated as the domestic product or the domestic income. So the criteria is the production units should be located within the domestic territory to give you the domestic product or the domestic income. Whereas for the national product or the national income, the consideration is all the producers who are normal residents of an economy. As long as the producers are normal residents of the economy, from wherever they are going to generate the income, whether from within the domestic territory or from rest of the world, all that will make up the national income. I repeat, under national income or national product, all the producers who are normal residents of an economy, they are considered to be contributing towards the national product or the national income. That's a second point. The third is, domestic income does not include NFIA. Because very clearly we have understood that domestic income is only the income that is generated within the domestic territory. So it does not include NFIA or net factor income from abroad. Whereas national income is the income that is made by normal residents from within the domestic territory and from abroad. So that very much includes the net factor income from abroad. So those are the three points of differences between domestic income and national income. Number one, domestic income is a territorial concept, whereas national income is a national concept. Number two, domestic income considers all the production units within the territory, within the domestic territory, and national income considers the income that is made up by the normal residents of the nation. And number three, domestic income does not include NFIA, and national income, it includes NFIA. So those are the differences between domestic income and national income. Now, moving on to the adjustments that can be made to arrive at the domestic income or the national income or any aggregate from one particular aggregate, what is to be done? We will see that. Let's assume you are given the GDP MP and you will have to arrive at the domestic income, which is basically the NDP FC. So gross domestic product at market price, it includes depreciation, whereas the domestic income does not include its a net value. So remove depreciation, and then you have the GDP MP, whereas your domestic income is at factor cost. So from market price to factor cost, you need to reduce NIT to arrive at this particular aggregate. So GDP MP less depreciation less NIT will give you NDP FC, or the domestic income. Now if you want to arrive at the national income, what are the adjustments that you need to do? Again, let's assume you are given the GDP MP and the NNP FC, or the national product, the national income is what you want to arrive at. So this is a net term, this is gross term. So from gross to net, remove depreciation. This is a domestic concept, this is a national concept. So from domestic to national, you need to add NFIA, because along with the domestic income, only if you are going to add the net factor income received from abroad, it becomes a national concept. And then this is at market price. Now your national income is always at FC or factor cost. So from MP to FC, you should remove NIT, because you know that NIT, which is IT minus subsidies, it increases the market price, and to the extent of subsidy, it reduces the market price. So to give you the correct indicator, which is the FC, remove NIT. So then you arrive at the national income or the national product, which is NNP FC. So this is how from one aggregate you can arrive at the other. Now for the reverse, what you need to do? Let's say you are given the NNP FC and you are supposed to arrive at the GDP MP. So from this particular aggregate to the other one, you have net concept. So you need to add depreciation. You have a national concept here. What you want to arrive at is a domestic concept. So you need to remove NFIA, which is the net factor income from abroad. And you have a factor cost concept here. You need to arrive at the market price. So you need to add the NIT. So thereby you arrive at the gross domestic product at market price. So this is how, given one particular aggregate, you can make adjustments and you can arrive at the other aggregates. So now I think you are ready to take on few basic numericals related to both the domestic as well as the national income aggregates. Keep watching. Thank you.